Note to self. Next time you see Lorne Michaels, thank him personally for having his team search you out Friday night on an Easter Sunday weekend, a resurrection weekend, to rise the phoenix from the ashes again. You see, the Jesus uncrossed has more major significance than those who criticize it will realize, and those who appreciate it might know. They never said Jesus was coming back as Jesus. They never said Jesus was a black man. There's a lot of things they never said. They never said that Jesus was going to come back and be nice, or did they? Maybe you need to read those books again. They never said Jesus was the only answer. And in the bit, Jesus doesn't refer to the Father as God, or does he? Or has God the Creator? And God is not the dog backwards. You see, there are 13 keys to the mystery of life known to man. They don't talk about them a lot. You have them on a need to know, or a need to disclose, or a need to execute. Some have them from birth. Some will never acquire them. When you master them, it opens up a whole new panacea. It opens up a whole new Pandora's box at the same time. And the panorama of your journey will forever change. For those of you who believe in one life, one existence, and no afterlife, I still pity you deeply. For those of you who believe in reincarnation, that you're going to come back as an ant or a butterfly, good luck with that mission. How myopic. For those of you who believe in reincarnation, you're at least on the right step. I'll take a walk. For those of you who understand the concept of incarnation, you're getting warmer. There may be more than 13 keys with the Creator on the mystery of life from infinity to infinity, but you'll never know that until you totally cash in everything and invest in the knowledge that cannot be taught in schools. Not at the level I'm talking about. A lot of it you'll end up experiencing on your own through your own travels of time. And not the mystery you think of travels of time, or maybe it is, depending on how advanced you are in your expansion of thinking. This is well beyond what we have seen to capture in humanity. History, his story, he who paid for it, he who wrote it, he who bought it, he who swallowed it. That's history. Most of it is folklore and bullshit. But there are significant stories that can be garnered from it if you can interpret through all of the distortion and noise that's cluttered with it. The infiltration of someone trying to push their own agenda through a message veiled as religion or politics or truth. What is the real truth? And does anybody really know what time it is? Well, for that dimension, which incarnation you're in. If you don't believe you've ever lived before, you need to dig deeper. If you don't believe you'll live again, then you've got to start digging the hole to reality so you can see the light of your future, of your past, and of your present. When you can become omnipresent in all dimensions and not dwell too much in any of them and still appreciate the moment, you're about to open the door to secrets yet known only by few. I did promise I'd be back, even if I faded away. The question is, how long will the dimensions be between the fades and the returns? Born on this planet, in Michigan, the creator's joke on the world, right at the tip of Michigan, ironically right there. It really doesn't matter where I'm from, even if I'm an alien. Which doesn't mean I'm from a foreign country, you boneheads. By the definition you've given it. Or extraterrestrial, or call it what you want. With today's artificial intelligence and the majority lack of intelligence in human beings, we rely on machines to think for us. To remember numbers, to remember dates, times, places, locations, photographs, videos. We are dumbing down the more we're making our machines smarter. I remembered numbers better in the 60s when I had to dial them on a frickin' rotary phone or push them into a push-button phone as we advanced beyond giving me blisters on my index finger. Or wearing off an eraser off a pencil because I got tired of using my finger when I was dialing so many people on news stories as a child. Some of us learn our purpose in life never, because we won't do the digging that's required. Some of us refuse to accept the gifts we were given and take a different journey because we don't want to sell out for artistic reasons, or we can't stand people and we want to get off grid, or because we've just put up with enough of life's bullshit, we don't want to do it anymore. And few of us will ever see the mystery of the light until we look through it. Not into it. See beyond the light. See into the next light and beyond that light. In the infinite worlds of wisdom, and I did say worlds, there is higher intelligence than Earth. And while you think you're so goddamn smart all the time, you've barely scratched the sand in time. With all of your masses in the material world, whether religious or of inventories and properties, it doesn't get you to where you're going until you get there. And on the journey, there are usually just a lot of distractions and a lot of maintenance and a lot of upkeep and a lot of paranoia and a lot of things that go with the responsibility of the masses. When you strip it all down to the naked truth, we'd be better off if we walked around with nothing on any time. It's harder to lie that way because people will still be able to see what they see, despite what you tell them, even if you're a master of illusion. And some of the mystery success is done through illusion. Is it success, or how many bodies were buried along the way? Ask any president who will tell the truth, any world leader who will tell the truth. There's carnage along the way. Ask a head of company. There's carnage on the way. Maybe they got up and walked again, and rose up and found a new way, but there were casualties along the way. People's careers were killed, their home lives were killed. People build careers on the backs of others. Sometimes knowingly, sometimes unknowingly. Because there are those martyrs who will never complain. Because they're there for you to get to where you need to go. The building blocks of your journey sometimes are built on the backs of others. Sometimes they were employed helpers who consented. Sometimes there were people who volunteered because they saw your vision and knew that they couldn't help you get there all the way, but they could at least help you get to another step or two. If you don't show gratitude to those people in act and in deed and return those favors through your karma to others, you will forever be a lost soul. Part of the thing that they've been trying to tap in for me for years, aside from quick wit, humor, and sarcasm has been my ability to understand and interpret things that others can't. It's been when they can get me to focus on something, they know I'll never do it half-assed because I'm such a perfectionist. Because I know that this is real. And I don't want a second take if it's him or me what it's going to be. And I blinked. Because I know what happens in that movie. Been there, done that too many times. And so far, I have not been the blinky. I have not been the blinker. I don't miss a fucking beat. And thank you for the Catholic Church for that personal word. Fornication under Cardinal Knowledge. It's an acronym that became a word that was so versatile. Let's go have a fantastic time. Or fuck me, fuck you, or fuck you, or fuck them. And what the fuck? WTF. Yet people get so enraged when they use it. Yet they use it too. At some moment in life, you blurted out your fuck, whether it was verbally or in thought and in deed. So get the fuck out of my business unless you're invited in. And stay out of my personal life, which has nothing to do with my professional life, and it has nothing to do with my government contracting anywhere on this motherfucking planet. At no point did I make it personal with your family, yet you've made it very personal with mine. At no point did I make it personal with your friends, yet my friends have told me of adventures where we've been tormented, followed, and even interrogated by the men in black. 9 different ones by some people. And some of them, who had no connection to the others in different parts of the city or the world, told me the same stories within a matter of hours. So it's not my delusion and paranoia that Uncle Sam and high-level intel and high command is not happy with Uncle Kurt's latest performances. I got the message loud and clear, very directly from the FBI in front of witnesses. I've had the message loud and clear from the State Department in front of witnesses, from DSS PII, from Protective Services, Department of Homeland Paranoia, and all the other 18 known agencies in this part of the world, not including the others I interface with around the planet, and from people at the UN, who I've also interfaced with for the last 2 centuries, several decades, but who's counting. But I digress back to the times when everyone told me it wouldn't happen, and I said it would happen or else. And the or else happened, and I got a White House endorsement, got an ABC approval, got a UN approval, a UNICEF approval, and approval of peacekeeping troops on the ground. And as a kid from Northern Michigan, I got that back for when I ended up down in Central America on a fact-finding mission on an all-expense-paid trip, Wahoo, that was handpicked by the White House. Isn't it interesting if it was handpicked during a sensitive time in the world, a changeover in administrations, and then ironically, a few years later, I married into that White House and administration through the Baker clan? Because I was reminded down in Dallas, Texas, that Kennedy was shot there, and I was related to him, and they knew that, and despite all the heinous bullshit his daughter had put me through, I was going to marry Edward L. Baker's daughter, Lee Jane, because Howard and James were his cousins, and they were the chief of staff and secretary of state for guess who, and out in the bushes, 75 yards out were 3 CIA sharpshooters. He told me that when I stepped out to smoke a cigarette before getting married. And that I was going to be a known Democrat marrying into the Republican White House. To be followed by Maria and Anna. Somehow they already knew that was coming down. It hadn't been announced publicly at that point that I recall. Maybe it was, and I missed that blip with all the other psychodrama they were putting me through at the time. And, you know, my brother-in-law ended up being, you know, a top gun and a millionaire, multi-millionaire heir to, because of Avery Island, the Tabasco sauce fortune, and Beef Goodrich, and Rich Goodrich, as a colonel or captain at the time, buddy, was my brother-in-law. And his wife, my sister-in-law. Then also had their input into how Uncle Kurt should be thinking for many years. And then, in the next marriage, I didn't do any better. I married into high-level Lockheed Marriott, and DOD, high-level crypto read and burn, former Navy SEAL family. There's no former. Once a SEAL, always a SEAL. Once CIA, always CIA. Once FBI, always FBI, even if you get your ass fired, right? Much more. Told you that was going to happen if you fucked with me. Guess what happened? Uncle Kurt doesn't lie. Even when you push his buttons over tip, even when you waterboard the fuck out of me, you know the answers will still be the same, and eventually you'll end up letting me go because they're not going to change. And don't lie. You can drug the shit out of me, you're still going to get the same fucking answers, including a go fuck yourself. There's video that exists of this. You just have to get access to these files and their eyes only and read only and don't copy and go fuck yourself. I know where they're buried if you want to go get them. It's just getting past DOD and Fort Knox and all those other fucks. But that can be done. It's not that tough. They know that because Uncle Kurt's done more than once. This is not braggadocio. It's dope in your eyes. While you've seen me or heard me in television and film and radio and animation and video games and training stuff, and may not have even known it was me for decades. Movie trailers, TV promos. Pick a food category. Oh, I've done that too. Did you know I've also consulted Green Technologies for years, been the voice of the rainforest for years, have been fighting for your rights for years, no matter where you live on the planet, whether I know you or not? Not relevant. It was part of my mission on this planet. My mission's almost complete. I'm not coming back for Extinction 7. Good luck with that. You're about to wrap Extinction 6. At the rapidity you're doing it, pain ain't gonna be much longer. In less than 50 years, thanks to human genius and advanced technologies, they don't need you anymore. They don't want you anymore. You're just sucking up valuable resources. So get ready, your date's already scheduled for your extinction. Whether you want to believe that or not, I've given you all the keys on how to find your answers. No, not all of them. I've given you 7 of 13. There's 5 left to go. I haven't decided if I'm going to give them to you yet. I guess you'll have to wait and see. But the other 5, they don't have. And that's why they're still waiting to pull the trigger. They're hoping I'll give them up this time. I guess we'll have to wait and see. Because the Creator's will be done. And my mission here was not to stand in the way of free will. The other 5 keys are out there. But I didn't tell you what they were when I was giving them to you. So you're going to have to dig through a lot of fucking footage if you want to find them easily. Otherwise, you're just going to have to wait and see. And I'll drip them out again. I may or may not identify them. But if you're wise, maybe you'll start taking notes and learning from them. maybe you'll start to dig and ask more questions. But even when you ask more questions, remember, you can find any answer to anything I've said by just asking the questions on Google. And ask them differently, in different phrases, different words, different keywords. Get creative. And you'll find the other five rapidly, if you know what you're looking for. Master the keys, and I'll meet you there on the journey. Fail to master the keys, I'll still meet you before the end of your time, and you will go exactly where I told you you're going. You can rest assured, I don't lie. Don't have to, don't need to. Waste of energy is kind of like fear. It's kind of like worry. Wasted energy. What will be, whether you like it or not. Whether you think you control it or not, whether you think you master it or not. The true test will be told in time. Did you master it all? And how well did you master it? And did you master it well enough for the master creator who wrote the keys? Good luck.